A man suspected of shooting two bouncers at an after-hours strip club in Albuquerque is still on the loose. And now, in an interview you will see only on 7, the family of a similar shooting victim is calling for a safer work environment. Action 7 News reporter Liz McKernan has that story.
The Threadgill family says they could barely watch the news as they saw cops swarming TD's Fantasy World early Saturday morning. Two bouncers hit in the leg by gunfire and sent to the hospital.
For us, it was a fresh wound, just picked again.
Their son Joseph died last year in a similar shooting. Police say a man kicked out of the strip joint came back with a gun and killed the young bouncer.
Who trains these bouncers to be under what kind of protocol is going to be needed if a gun is presented? How many, and why isn't there more protection outside for them?
Police tell us they're still looking for the shooter and spent the day Tuesday interviewing witnesses, trying to figure out exactly who this man is and why he would shoot at the bouncers.
Alcohol is a common denominator, but at Fantasy World there's no alcohol served, but where are these individuals going prior to going to the strip clubs?
A question investigators plan on tackling as they continue their search for the gunman.
You were man enough to pull out the gun, be man enough to come and turn yourself in and pay the price for what you have done.
In Albuquerque, Liz McKernan, KYT, Action 7 News.
Police tell us the two victims from this weekend's shooting are expected to be